I'm Some Tech Guy and welcome back. Today, we're going to change the fans on an MSI Suprim X graphics card. This one is a 3070 Ti, but the process for all the 3070, 3080 and 3090 cards, both Suprim and Suprim X, is the same. It's really easy to do if you have a bad fan, and I'm going to show you how to do it in less than 10 minutes. Once we change the fans, I'm going to give you 4 important tips for buying your fans to prevent common problems that catch people out. You will need just one screwdriver, and we don't need to remove the backplate, heatsink, or touch the warranty sticker on the screw if you have one. We are going to just remove the screws in the fan shroud and in the fans themselves, and, as you will see, there are some useful pointers to make removing these easier. The fans connect to the header sockets, with the white header powering the two fans closest to the display output, and the black one powering the fan directly beside it. First, we're going to remove the 6 shroud screws. They are silver in colour with slightly rounded heads, as you can see here. When you remove these, adjust the fans so that you can get between the blades which are not joined. This will make things a lot easier to get the screws out. Carry on removing all of these. You will want to use a magnetic screwdriver for this. I'm using the iFixit Mako kit, which you can find linked below. The fans on the MSI Suprim cards are 95mm in diameter, as you can see here. Let's check my replacement fans are the correct size. They are, so I'm good to go. Now, let's unscrew the 9 black flat-headed screws fixing the fans into the heatsink and put them in a safe place, separate from the fan shroud screws. Now we're ready to remove the fan shroud. The plastic tabs that secure the fan shroud down sit below the fan blade, so you will need to rotate and adjust the fans to allow you to pass those tabs past the fans. Start on the side where the PCIe edge connector is, and once all the tabs are navigated past the fans, fold the shroud up and back carefully. You can see here that the shroud is still connected to the PCB by a couple of cables that are used to power and control the great looking RGB on this card. You can disconnect them, but there's no need, so let's just leave the shroud here. Next, we need to gently prise the aluminium cable retainers open enough to remove the fan cables, which you can see me doing here. When you're putting the new fans in, it's important that the cables are routed and held in these channels, or the shroud simply won't seat fully and be screwed in. Now, let's unplug the fan connectors from the header sockets. Give the cables a gentle wiggle left and right to get them out. The connectors are color-coded, with the white plug serving the two fans to the left and the black one serving the fan directly above it. My furthest left fan is broken, so I need to replace both the left side fans as they come in a pair. But for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm going to replace all 3. Let's get the new fans in place now. The hardest part of the job is getting the fans lined up on the screw holes, as the cable alignment can pull them off center. The best way to make this simple as possible is to place the fans directly on the screw holes where you can feel that they are keyed, meaning that there are indents in the fans that line up with the holes and stop them sliding around. Once each fan is in the right spot, hold it and route the cable into its aluminium clasps. You can screw the fans in before putting the shroud in place, but I prefer to leave them unscrewed until the shroud is down so they can be moved around to make the shroud fitment easier. You can also use the head of your screwdriver to help line up the holes. Once done, route the cables down to the header sockets where we will plug them in a little later. Now, let's get the shroud back in place. You can see here that the shroud screw tabs need to be maneuvered between the fan blades to get the shroud seated properly. This is where having the fans still unfixed makes things a little easier. Now, we screw the fans in. Get the first screw loosely into each fan, and then adjust the fans to line up using your screwdriver if needed. Then, tighten down each of the three screws. Repeat this process for all three fans. Now, give them a gentle spin just to make sure they're not fouling on anything, and then let's secure the shroud. After this is done, I'm going to give you those tips on buying your fans. And now, we're ready to push the header plugs back in. They are keyed, so check that you have them in the correct orientation. They should go in fairly easily with a firm push downwards. And now to those tips. First of all, tip 1, get the correct fan model numbers. I will put the ones found on my fans in this unit in the comments below. This is a great way to start with your search for your fans. Tip 2, check the dimensions of the fans to make sure you get the correct fit. The model number is not an assurance, and most sellers also state the dimensions. Again, I have posted these in the comments, but it's not just about the fan diameter, it's the screw hole dimensions and the fan depth also. Tip 3, you can get the fans more cheaply without the embossed sticker. But again, check the dimensions as a model number may be a little different. Also, if you are changing all three, this won't be as noticeable as if you only change one. Tip 4, check the cable lengths. I have seen fans that look correct, even had the correct model number, but one of the cables was too short and wouldn't reach the header socket. And a big thank you for watching. I hope this will help you get your MSI GPU fixed quickly and cost effectively. If this was useful, I would love a like or please subscribe for more videos like you see here. And as always, see you in the next.